Hi twins, thank you so much for tuning in. My name is Chandler. This is your intuitive energy reading for this week. Today is the 7th, and so you can count on these energies playing out from now until the 14th. This is a little bit of an astrology and tarot forecast for the collective of masculines and feminines. There's a lot of healing to be done this month, but this week specifically is going to be vital for the potential of the relationship as well as the individual on a soul level. A lot is being illuminated within the astrology of the week. And as far as the collective during Scorpio season, there's a lot to revisit, a lot of hidden truths being discovered, a lot of psychological awakenings, a lot of philosophical revisions. Okay, what is it that you deserve? What is required of you? How do you want to feel? And then really gaining perspective over if that's possible in the current situation with your twin. You know, a lot of us in the collective are having to really face the facts this week. It's going to be very illuminating. You're going to be exposed to feelings within yourself that may have been long forgotten. And that can be really liberating. It can be eye-opening, okay? As to your truer feelings of the situation, whatever that may be for you. So it's my hopes and my intention within this reading to clarify how the masculine is feeling on a soul level and how the feminine is feeling on a soul level. Of course, when we're in the physical, our egos tend to camouflage a lot of the truth behind how our souls feel about situations that we're currently experiencing. There could be some karmic stuff come up, karmic partners, karmic judgments. There can also be some triggers that come up revolving, third-party involvement, blockages, addictions, that kind of thing. This month is going to be very vital in exposing a lot of those things. The deeper programmings, the, templates that may be outdated, and generational codes, and, really breaking through those barriers is what I see the twins doing, but it doesn't come without real heavy lifting, okay, from both sides. So, again, just sort of keep an open mind as I read the cards and as I intuit the information. This is on a soul level, and so though your twin may not be in your life or able to say these things directly to you, this is how their soul feels about any given situation. And then we'll go into the astrology as we go as well. In fact, let me pull that up real quick. So we're going to be going into the masculines first and then the feminines. So how are you guys adjusting to daylight savings time? I'm not cool with it. It gets dark at like 4:30. Not cool at all. But like the season we're in, we are headed into the darkest time of the year. This is considered the darkest season. The season where the veil is the thinnest. And so a lot of us could be having psychic revelations. We could be meeting our twin a lot in the realm. We could be exchanging messages telepathically or on a soul level, effortlessly. You could also be receiving insights, awakenings, realizations. And because we are having the astrology we have currently, it could present a bit of a psychological shift or crisis, depending on what is revealed. Okay, we have Mars in Libra, direct Saturn in Capricorn, and it's actually squared. So this is an exact square, and Saturn is talking about the limiting desires of Mars, okay? Where it is as a collective we realize certain things or come to these realizations on our own, we're going to have to really slow down to reconsider our reactions. Where we find resistance in relationships or even opposition, creating apprehension, creating frustration, creating blockages essentially to our desires and lasting progress with our twin. This is going to be important that you don't simply react to situations, that you handle these crises, that you handle this opposition in a more mature way. Because Saturn ultimately will challenge you in the hardest ways, but it is in fact to create a more sturdy foundation within the individual. And so as you feel very reactive and angry, you're going to have to try your hardest to deal with this in a mature way, and to maybe hold back some of those egoic tendencies or words that may actually hinder your success in the long run. So avoiding any tower moments is definitely advised, but then also not to simply, conform, right? To keep your integrity, to keep your vision, okay, of what it is you deserve intact. Because what this is actually doing in the long run with Mars in Libra and Saturn in Capricorn is helping you establish that foundation. It's actually helping you master your reality, okay? And there's certain qualifications that are necessary, like steps or schooling, okay, to achieve and receive this reality that you see in the future. So again, I mean, this is a very confusing time because, of course, with Scorpio season, it's highly emotional. It's very reactive. It's very upsetting. It's very triggering. It's talking about deep wounds or trauma that may have been directly caused by your twin. That you're going to have to refrain from projecting upon them and instead look within about what it is you know you deserve, what it is isn't working with you or doesn't fit into that reality that you're currently creating. So then we have Mars in Libra, quincunx Neptune retrograde in Pisces. Now, I know that that's kind of, it's far out there thinking. When we're talking about the mastering of reality that we're trying to consider, a lot of this is actually going to come in the form of illusion. A lot of this has been illusion. A lot of this has been what either we or our twin have been unaware of. That the reality that we so desire that's coming up with Mars and Libra as far as our relationships and what we're taking action toward or what we're diving into or what we've been striving for is actually not tangible. It's actually where this is coming into play. It's really highlighting things that we either were unaware of or we were just not considering the consequences of. We were not thinking clearly. We were not thinking long term. So Mercury in retrograde is actually assisting us in revisiting or viewing these circumstances from a more tangible angle. You know, if you have a twin with severe addictions, you might need to consider how this will affect your children. You know, a lot of us twins have missions to have children with our twins and to bring in or usher in that new era. But if you are aware that your twin has a severe addiction, codependency issues, abandonment issues, or blockages regarding third-party situations, and you feel like you can't trust this person, well then, how is that going to affect any future outcome with you? Are you going to live your life in paranoia? Are you going to live your life constantly suspicious of them? Have they done anything to truly eradicate how you feel about your twin? These are the kind of questions that are going to be putting in perspective, am I living in a disillusionment that I can have a tangible relationship with them again? Is this mission at this point now an illusion? What is it that needs to happen so that I can start thinking about this long term? How is this gonna work? What do I need so that I can build off of this, or we can build this foundation together? You know? So I don't know if that makes sense now, but it's definitely going to make sense later in the week. There's going to be questions, okay, that come up. And it's very, very deeply self-reflective. And when we have Neptune in Pisces, especially as it's retrograde, these are the rose-colored glasses coming off. This is true honesty moving forward. Like, there may not even be animosity toward the end of the week with what you've discovered or what you realize. It may just be very clear-cut and simple. It may just be an aha moment for you that you get to finally release or surrender to this new vision. Okay, in a much more tangible way, because again, bottom line, you're building a foundation. And if you can't build a foundation with this person, then you're gonna move forward and build it on your own or with someone else. So November 11th is a very significant energy day for the collective. November 11th is 11-11. And this is going to be bringing and solidifying those greater awakenings. It's the ultimate illumination day. On that day, we have Mercury conjunct the Sun, which is actually called a Kazemi at 18 degrees. This is bringing alchemical transformation of emotional stagnation, where things have been unclear. Where things have been unclean, these bondages are literally being purified by fire. Now, when we say Mercury is retrograde, of course, but when it's conjunct the sun, that means they're working in harmony to bring alchemy, to any issue maybe revolving around ego. To any issue that has not been moving forward or n really needed the power of the sun, which is, the king force, the authority, the illumination, the central I am agent, so that we can have momentum. Getting very in touch with our personalities. Our purpose, maybe outside of the twin dynamic. Okay? So anything unclean between the two of you, I think is going to be purified because a lot of what you are having to revisit within yourself is going to become more clear. It's going to be direct. A lot of clear truths, illuminations, and progressive emotional movement. There's been an interesting dynamic within the collective as just going back and forth, like not knowing for sure if like we want something with that person or if they can even rise to the occasion. A lot of us twins are losing hope because our counterpart has just been super unaware. There's just been, especially, and I hate to say this, masculines, but it's sort of been a Mars influence for you guys because, women are from Venus, men are from Mars. This previous month, Venus just started moving in Scorpio. For a while, Mars and Venus were like kind of doing a little dance in the sky, and Venus took off into Scorpio. Mars is being held back. Okay, Mars is really dealing with some blockages. Mars is really dealing with some deeper stuff, maybe revolving around self-improvement or accountability. And so the twins are not currently aligned. But with this deeper reflective masculine, this deeper reflective agent, masculines, you're going to be able to take action. Though no action may take place on the 11th, your internal world will shift substantially this day, and the action that you need to take will become more clear. Okay, so the back and forth is really sort of what's been holding you back. There's going to be a decision made within yourself, though no action may take place then. What action needs to happen will undoubtedly be illuminated. Okay? So that day, too, we have Mercury transiting the Sun. So as we have the Kazemi with the Sun conjunct Mercury, Mercury conjunct Sun, we have this transit happening. So if you have the right telescope, you can actually see Mercury in front of the Sun. Okay? This is a very rare occasion. And it's happening on this day. It's a very rare astrological event. And so as I say, there's this clarifying agent, this emotional movement. It's essentially eclipsing everything that's been holding us back from making personal progress. Personal progress as well as the progress with our mate or our twin. Okay? It's gonna be undeniable. There's gonna be communication either from your twin or from the universe. There is no questioning after this point. At least that's where you should be. Now, if you're still questioning by the full moon in Taurus, which is the next day, November 12th, the universe is going to be hitting you even harder with information that you've needed to helpfully bring awareness, bringing up stuff, bringing things to the light, exposing illusions, impermanence, or false conceptions, character flaws, possessiveness, codependency, and unhealthy boundaries, needs within us that are not being met, so that you can work very diligently on that for the next 2 weeks. And the universe is like, we told you that there was no choice. We told you that this year was going to be bringing finalities. We told you that you can't bring this stuff into the new decade. You know, a lot of people haven't realized this. 2020 is a new decade. It's a new decade. From 2010 and on, what have you done? Where have you gone? What things have come up? You've probably realized a lot, done a lot of work. Your whole life is not the same as it once was. It really is important during this new decade that you started off on the right foot. So this clarifying agent coming through with the full moon in Taurus is helping you bring these illuminations and grounding them. Bringing the awakenings through and solidifying it. There may not be any going back after this day. And so that's why I think this reading is important, that we really align with the energies that the universe is giving us, because it requires a surrender. It requires a releasing of resistance, okay? Especially for the masculines, okay? So then on the 13th, we have Mercury sextile Saturn trine Neptune, which is that rose-colored glasses energy that we were talking about. As those glasses come off, there's a renewed creative sense, artistic sense, our interpretations of scenarios may be revealed that they weren't actually based in reality, or that we've just been somewhere else. You know, a lot of mercurial energy wanting us to move forward with the new realizations, and what the creative or artistic flair is kind of helping us make light of heavier issues, so that we can do something constructive with them. So that we can, like, oops, kind of energy, like, whoopsies, what can I do? Where can I find inspiration from this mistake I've made, essentially? Okay, so, you know, it's very interesting. When we have so much of this energy going on, there can be so many things happen for you guys. So this is not going to resonate with everyone. A lot of us will probably be seeing deeper side effects of this as well than even what I'm addressing. So it could be a fairly heavy week. Today is Thursday. I would say since Tuesday, Monday or Tuesday, there's been quite a heavy hitting collective energy. Friday to next Tuesday should be leveling out and into more of that psychic, clairvoyant kind of ethereal energy. Okay. So just so you guys know, I'm kind of rambling now. But that's the astrology, you guys. That's where we are as a collective. And that's what is happening with the divine masculines and feminines. Feminines, I think that it might require quite a bit of compassion from you. if you're not feeling like your masculine is really developing or hearing you, I really kind of feel like the feminines are tired of playing teacher. There's been an energy of like lessons and teaching with the feminines. That is going to subside. That's not your job. There's really an interesting energy of, that maturity energy, the maturity level coming with Saturn. Like, there's an energy from the feminines wanting to nurture this relationship, but there's a fine line between nurturing and smothering. And so the feminines are needing to just completely release from the masculines so that the masculines can make their own independent situations better, their own independent feelings healed. There's definitely an energy of, okay, now you show me what you've learned. Now you show me what you know, what you're capable of. I need some validation, or I need some proof of all the work we've done. And I guess from teacher role, from being so involved, you're actually taking a much more observing energy, but releasing what the outcome may be. Masculines, I feel like there's a lot of karma associated with your energy right now, needing to take action to remove blockages for good. Put a sort of finalized energy upon blockages, no longer being here and there, really being direct in action or intent. Okay. Now, I'm sorry if you guys can hear that. They're doing construction outside or something. Masculines, please. Please show me what I need to see for the masculines. This energy is taking a long time to sort of ripen in my cards, which I think is specific to the masculine because it may feel like it's taking a long time with the masculines. There's a slow development there, and maybe even some very deeply egoic or emotional blockages that hinder, hinder their progress within the twins' relationships. Masculines. Okay, listen, masculines, you had a very deep awakening. We have the Sun and the Five of Wands. You've had a very deep awakening. This 11-11 day is going to be very, very important for your progress. There's been some inner conflict. This inner conflict is really highlighting how much more you desire your own peace. This inner conflict and the exhaustion of being, back and forth, the feeling that nothing ever is very progressive, though you may be putting efforts in, it's very contradictory to how you really want to feel. So, as big or grand as some of these realizations may be, it's actually very simple. The Sun card would suggest that. It's actually very simple. What things do not serve you? What things create more conflict? What things are sabotaging your peace or success? The Sun is also talking about the mission, okay? As I said before, as I think it's a very big topic here within the Twin Flame Collective, a lot of you did come here to start families together, to usher in new star seeds and generations to come, raise spiritual beings. The spirits of your children are oftentimes with you for years before they actually incarnate. And I feel like some of you masculines might actually be able to feel your children around you. You might actually be able to see or get validation of this some way. And you see the mission at hand, you see what your future may hold, but you're really fighting your past. You're really fighting something. There's quite a bit of opposition here that stands between you and your mission. Now, this can be competition. If there's third party involvement, if there's addictions, these act as blockages, okay? Not just to your twin, but to your mission, to your ultimate happiness, because the Sun is ultimate happiness. And I do feel like a lot of you masculines kind of feel like you're getting this second chance or second wind, pep in your step. But then you feel like you're constantly coming up against that opposition that we were talking about. So it's very important that you keep your eye on the prize. That's the kind of energy that I'm getting with this sun, is that maybe it's not for your twin necessarily that you are having to keep your eye on the prize, but there is definitely something between you and your peace of mind, you and your independence, you and your personal growth that really, really needs to be addressed. This is the energy of the Four of Swords. This is the energy of kind of getting your thoughts all together. Gathering your thoughts, making sense of what you know, making sense of what you've learned. Maybe taking a break for a while, taking a mini vacay, getting out of town so that you can just sort of refresh your mental space. It's just been a lot around you right now. There's been a lot of distractions, a lot of distractions, and I do feel like that's on purpose. There are probably people who are jealous around you. There's probably third party involvement or people who see what you're capable of obtaining and just have that sort of jealousy within them to try to sabotage it. Now, this is maybe only for a few of you guys, but I really feel like you need to start collecting this information in a logical way, not giving in to the distractions, not giving in to the temptations, not being trapped again in competitive measures, things that ultimately are there to sabotage you. It's just simple. Okay, some of you could be going back to rehab or seeking counsel as well, for the things that you know aren't healthy for you long term. The sun is an energy of commitment as well. So like if you're not committing to your twin, then you're doing a recommitment to yourself this week. You're doing a recommitment because there's something in your life that has been shown to you in an undeniable fashion. The things in the physical could be really out of alignment. You could be carrying multiple burdens right now because of what errors in judgment you've previously made. So there's something you're doing this week that is setting a new course for you, though you know you're going to be standing against opposition or competition or temptation, addictions, codependency issues, deep emotional trauma. It can be so varying for the collective. But it's truly within you to do so, because what you want is more powerful than what you've had. What you see for yourself is more important, than your past mistakes. There is a redeeming effect here, and it's for the long term. When we see the sun and the child energy, it's about personal growth. You don't have a child one day and then not have a child the next day. This is about having a child, having a rebirth, having an enlightening moment that really does change very many things from there on. Okay, so the Queen of Cups, Six of Wands, and Nine of Swords. This is interesting. As we're talking about moving toward the feminine, the Queen of Cups is the feminine. The Six of Wands is a Leo energy, and the Nine of Swords is Libran. We're looking at wanting to move toward the feminine and feeling very confident, feeling very victorious or strong for her. Just for the sake of this reading, I'm going to say her and him for the feminine and masculine. Okay, though, as you guys know, it can be vice versa. They're wanting to move toward the feminine in a confident way. Something about this feels as if they don't feel adequate at this time. They could have a lot of anxiety about their past mistakes. They could be wanting to move away from those, maybe create some space before actually approaching the feminine. Because the feminine is coming through to the masculine. How the masculine is seeing the feminine is very nurturing, very deeply emotional, very sincere, okay, about her feelings toward the masculine. But in her cup, her cup runneth over on her own. Okay? Though they know they have this spiritual union, and though they know that they have this affinity on a soul level, they also know that the Queen of Cups is very psychic, very, very spiritual on a soul level, very strong. And so I don't feel like they want to bring any negative situations into the feminine's life. Or at least that's the advice, that if you do have addictions, if you have social groups that are going to be sabotaging your success, if they bring addictions toward your feminine, the universe is not going to have this. The universe can't have both. So if the advice is to leave social groups that are not going to benefit or really have compassion toward this twin flame union healing, then there is absolutely no room for it within the connection itself. Okay? The Queen of Cups and the Six of Wands are wanting to come together, but in the background there's this Nine of Swords. And where is this Nine of Swords coming from? These blockages, these addictions, this stuff that is not, that actually can't be in a twin flame relationship. And I hate to say it, you guys, but as long as there are third party involvement, sexual based, romantic based, you know, friend based, that compromise the integrity of the two twin flames being together in unison, it's just, it'll destroy the twin flame union. So it's not like the feminine is coming toward the masculine by saying, you've got to do this, you've got to do that. It's not ultimatum energy. It's just simply spiritual energy. It can't happen. There is only one way. There is only one way. And the masculine is having a difficult time accepting that they can't have both, that they can't be in this unhealthy social dynamic and have their feminine. They can't be in this addiction and bring their feminine into it. Their feminine is done with oppression. Their feminine is done with feeling like they don't have a strong voice. Their feminine is done with conforming toward the masculine's needs. The feminine is already, do you know what I'm saying? The feminine's already decided what they deserve, what they're going for. And if the mission doesn't happen, that's okay. But the feminine is not waiting anymore for things to, you know, to try out new things. So that's where they stand. They're not compromising. They're not even thinking about entertaining or giving license to third-party relationships. They are not considering that. And that's giving the masculine a lot of anxiety. That's giving the masculine a lot of worry, because there is no gray area. It's one or the other. And unfortunately, I'm not sure how this will end up for either party because of that. The moon in reverse. So the secrets, the realizations, the things that you may not have been aware of since you've known your twin are now being validated and confirmed or undeniable, okay, about this person's situation. And let me just reiterate, I don't feel that the feminine has any animosity toward the masculine's preferences. It's not a personal opinion kind of thing. The Queen of Cups and the Six of Wands show me that the masculine may be viewing the feminine in a very traditional way. Someone who has conformed, or someone who is not in touch with their sexuality or their own personal preferences or freedom of expression. When I think it's in fact much more about the principality, like whatever has been hidden and now is coming to the light, is not something that the feminine can entertain because it absorbs too much of their energy. It would compromise the feminine's voice. It would compromise who the the feminine is, or even to a further extent, the connection within the bond. You can't bring in these addictions to the feminine's life. They're not going to do that. They're not going to allow that. They're never going to give license to someone using their energy in those ways. And it's not about preference. The feminine could have been a freaking freak for the masculine, but the masculine may have lied. The masculine may have betrayed. The masculine may have literally chose these things over the feminine. And that's what truly hurts. That the feminine feels the masculine was so blind that they would allow something like this to compromise the integrity of the union. And they're done. There's even some feminines that are going as far as to block the masculine because of whatever uncompromising energy the masculine has shown them. See? Judgment. Judgment in reverse after this Four of Swords energy. Someone needs to get their mind right. Someone needs to get their thoughts right. The Four of Swords is absolutely rehab. It's rehab for some of you guys. This judgment is some bad karma, some bad deeds, some big mistakes because someone wasn't thinking clearly. Someone just didn't see. Someone just wasn't aware. They didn't want to see. They didn't want to admit to themselves. There's definitely an energy of denial here. Which I think is kind of sad because now we have judgment in reverse. This is definitely about being blocked, the Four of Swords. Energetically, you're going to know if you're blocked because, you know, you're not going to have access to the feminine if these situations aren't eradicated very soon. Even if you can access them in the realm or in dream time, none of it will make much sense. And you'll just have a feeling the telepathy will be gone and they'll no longer be entertaining anything involving this kind of situation. So if you're involved with a social group, I guess it is kind of like an ultimatum because the universe has told the feminine and what the feminine feels is that it's not like you can have both. You can't have me and have this. The feminine is thinking of the mission and how it would affect the future. And there's absolutely no way in hell that they're willing to accept these kind of circumstances and bring family into it and bring a future into it and start relying upon the masculine in any way unless they've seen a dramatic change. And I think the feminine is in a way losing hope because we have judgment, the Ace of Wands, and the Devil in reverse. So they're releasing themselves from toxicity, or at least that's the advice for the masculine. Okay, this can be put into very simple terms. Anything that's toxic, anything that compromises the spiritual union here, we have basically God and the devil going head to head about this arrangement, about this toxic behavior. The Ace of Wands is a staff. It's phallic energy. It's talking about addictions, things that really aren't what the masculine really likes, but instead it's sort of a short-lived fix or a kick. And it compromises the longevity of anything else. You know, it really does. It's very toxic energy coming through there. And the spiritual realm, Archangel Michael, you know, God, the universe is saying no more of this. this cannot be. You cannot bring in, this is the masculine trying to bring in the toxicity into the feminine's life. Bring the feminine into realms where they have no voice, they have no control. On a soul level, they're going to appear very innocent. They're going to appear very naive because that's their soul talking to you. You know, if they're not fully awake, they have limited control. And how dare you try to bring this stuff into the feminine's life if they have no say for themselves? That was a wrong move. That was a really terrible idea. And it really showed the feminine, literally, that the masculine's unwilling to leave situations or has not gotten the clarity that they need as far as what damage they are doing currently. What damage they are doing, what they are capable of doing with this energy. It's very, very toxic, very, very negative. And the feminine's just not having it. The feminine will block the masculine. If they don't get their mind right, if they don't get their situation fixed soon. All right. That's some heavy energy. That's some really heavy energy, masculines. There's definitely a feeling of sacrifice here. Like you're going to either sacrifice this toxic situation, the people who are completely incompassionate, who don't support the twin flame union, and the habits of this social dynamic, or you lose your twin. And this seems very, very final. Very, very final. Okay? We're still in the masculine's energy, so I do feel like the Hanged Man is another major arcana. Piscean, Neptunian energy about those rose-colored glasses needing to come off. Like, I don't know what the masculine's been thinking. I really don't. Like, they probably think that the feminine is like, I don't know, just like kind of whimsical or like lackadaisical or naive, which is kind of funny because it's actually the opposite. It's like literally the opposite. This is a projection. This is a projection of the masculinity being naive to a certain extent, of the feminine's integrity, the feminine's power, their principality. Needless to say, masculines, if you've done the feminine wrong and you haven't come correct or apologized, your mouth may be full of lots of things other than apologies. And the feminine is not having it. And so you have a really major life decision to make soon. And I mean like very soon, because this energy is very, very final. Four of Wands underneath. Some of you, this masculine will realize the error in their judgment. The rose-colored glasses of like, oh shit, I'm going to lose my twin. What did I say? Just confirming, you guys. It's just a waiting game at this point for the masculines, like, or for the feminines, I mean. Now, I know I've come down hard on masculines, but truly this energy is very, very based in masculine energy. Yeah. Very, very, very based in masculine energy. The hardship, the sacrifice, the rose-colored glasses kind of energy. It's very based in masculine energy. Let's switch over to the feminines. Oh, man. Feminines, I can already feel this energy is like, being in your power, but be very careful not to overassert yourself. Because I think the masculine has an impression that you may not be as emotional as you are, or as affected by the situation as you have been. And it is kind of important that you don't wear that authority mask just for show or out of egoic reasons. It's really time to get out of the ego and be in your power and know what to accept or what not to accept. But reserve some of that hostility. Reserve some of that, I want to say like condemnation. Like, don't condemn this person if they're trying to change. But if they're not trying to change, then there's definitely going to be some hostility. There's definitely going to be some feelings of resentment if you can't make your mission happen. So, feminines, please come through. Show me what I need to see for the feminines. Page of Pentacles in reverse. Let's see what else comes out. Okay, Ten of Wands, Four of Pentacles, and Knight of Wands. So this is an interesting energy. The overall energy is Page of Pentacles in reverse. Now, I really feel feminines, like what I was saying with the masculine situation over here. You're not investing anything, nothing, nothing. And not only are you saying no to this situation, but never to this situation. Very, very withdrawn energy coming from this card. Not investing a thing, not moving toward it, not making any moves, looking at the value of this situation and if there's any reciprocity in it. And I think a lot of you are just coming to the terms of no, okay? That's the kind of hostility that I'm feeling. It's not hostile necessarily toward the masculine. I don't feel like you want the masculine to suffer any more than they have. But yeah, you can't continue to give to this. That's what I feel for that. Then the way you see the masculine is that you know that they're like, they may be carrying a lot of burdens in their life, but they're also holding on to past stuff and not moving forward. And so it's hard to see this person in any kind of long-term or tangible way. Of course, when you're looking at the pentacles, you're looking at the tangibility of the future. You're looking at the tangibility of this mission. And the way you're seeing the masculine is this Knight of Wands. The Knight of Wands is a lot of passion, a lot of sexuality, a lot of force, you know, creative drive. But I wonder if you feel like it's actually worth it. I wonder if you feel like it's actually worth it or if it holds anything more. The feminine doesn't feel like this is an adequate offering because they see this energy of the four of pentacles, and they know that there's no substantial growth. They're not seeing any growth, and it's actually posing as quite a burden. Though they have a lot of feelings of passion and sexuality, and they want to do all kinds of things to their twins. Like, you missed that boat a long time ago when you betrayed me, or when you didn't respond to me, or when you were unfaithful, or when you cheated or lied or hid stuff. You know, how many ways can I say it? This boat has sailed for just the passion. You've got to do something different here. And there's a very, very different energy coming from the feminine. Very, very different. And I'm almost getting a little hostile. I'm almost getting a little detached resentment there because it's been such a burden on the feminines. And I just don't think the masculines have grasped that their involvement has been such an astronomical burden. The mistakes of the past, it's really caught up to the both of you. Strength in reverse. We've got a lot of Leo energy. Now, Leo is an interesting energy revolving around destiny, as we have the sun for the masculine as well. Strength in reverse can represent transparency. The transparency of the situation, what this masculine chose over you, has chosen, has given all of your energy between the two of you to, you're never going to give license to this. You're never going to be okay with this. You're never going to see a future with the masculine who's involved in a situation like this. Never. I really, really feel that. Because the Queen of Pentacles is coming up, very, very focused on home and family. They already have a foundation that they aren't willing to jeopardize for the hiccups that this masculine is bound to make if they continue to, you know, live in a non-reality. It's not only taking from the feminine and their energy resources, but it's taking from the masculine too. And I don't think the masculine sees it that way. I don't think the masculine has had any problem with things before the feminine's energy started showing up and, you know, spilling the tea. But it's going to be revealed to this masculine how much it has actually been to a detriment in their life or to themselves. Maybe not now, but in the future, it will. It will. It's a judgment. Ooh, yeah, so there's transparency here from the feminine. And the feminine is, you know, I feel like maybe that's why the masculine is looking at the feminine like they're a hoity-toity, or like they're very super traditional, and like, you know, they're looking at the feminine like they've got no sexual self-expression, or like it's just, you know, there's no chemistry, or the sexuality, it's not there. It's like, no, it's not there for you because you're in this situation. No, 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 no. The feminine is withholding, putting their sexuality on lockdown. Because they are this close to blocking the masculine altogether. If they keep treating the feminine as if she's disposable, as if her opinion doesn't matter, as if she's this, you know, this energy that just is like not into it. If that's not it, they're not into this. They're not into this shit. They're not into this crap. They're not into all of the drama and BS that's associated with it. And until you get your mind right, and until you get your intentions right toward the feminine, that passion is going to be on lockdown. Because they're not willing to jeopardize how far they've come, their energy resources. Sorry, masculines, the feminine is coming through very, very hostile. Very, very resentful. Because they've carried way too much of the weight. They've carried way too much of the burden. And they feel like the masculine has just been running amok with their energy. And they have, to an extent. What else for the feminine? So the feminine, I feel like, is very, very close to cutting off the masculine in a lot of ways. There's energy here of just non-negotiable. Seven of Cups and Knight of Cups. Inappropriate love, keeping their options open. You think that the feminine's going to be okay with this? You think that the feminine's going to be okay with living in some alternate universe or reality that's not real? You know, the masculine may have been running from the truth for a long time, and now that it's time to face it, they just want the feminine to start running with them. It's like, no, 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 no. Nobody's running. You can keep running. You can keep running. You can keep doing what you do. The feminine's never going to be okay with being someone's second choice. Not only that, but they're not anyone's option. The divine feminine is a divine feminine. They are in their empress energy. There is no feminine like the empress, and I really feel like feminines, you really need to embrace this, that if someone has loved you inappropriately and kept their options open and not apologized and just continued to do all of the things that you've literally told them will keep them from their happiness and from you, there is nothing you can do for this person. Wow. Six of Swords and the Chariot. These are both very, very fast-moving energies toward your peace. Like, literally moving away from this person, putting a block on this person. Energy, psychically, spiritually, whatever the case may be. You're getting healing, you're getting counseling, so that you can move away from this situation. And what you know, you can't unknow. What you've seen, you can't unsee. What has happened, you can't take back. And you literally may have to just put distance between you and this person. If your situation is that toxic, if your situation is that compromising, there's an energy of suppression. Like, this person really wants to suppress your voice. They like taking advantage of you in realms where you actually don't have a voice. You know, they like taking advantage of the fact that you may appear naive in the dream realm. They may like the fact that you can't choose or stop a situation if you're not enjoying it or if you know it's wrong. This person takes advantage of you, and I think you realize that it's time to get out before anything worse happens. Yeah, you can't be associated with this person if they're associated with those people. It'll never work. Your two energies will just rot. And it's sad because I think this person just wanted you to start doing what they do, or just start liking it and start participating in it and like not have to sacrifice it or do anything themselves. It's like, I don't know what they were thinking. I don't know what they've been thinking. But the universe is going to have their way with them. Because this person is facing a lot of judgment, a lot of negative karma for their past actions, but they're still doing them. And they're saying it's because they like it or because that's who they are or but it's like falling feels like flying for a little while too. That energy just came through like falling feels like flying for a little while. That's the energy of addictions. Have you guys seen the movie Coraline? I don't know why that just came up, but Coraline is an animated movie. It's actually geared towards children. But I read something about it that said that it's actually a metaphor for addiction. You know, in the movie, no spoiler alert, but you know how these movies go. Everything's fine, right? And it feels so good, and like they get everything they want, and it's like, why wouldn't we want to do this? But then in the long run, and of course, retrospect is always 20/20, this child realizes, wow, even though I thought I was so unhappy with what I had, or like it just wasn't good enough, I've realized what's replaced it is not the real thing. What's replaced it is not actually what I love. What's replaced it is not actually what's good for me. It keeps me hostage. It keeps me enslaved. It keeps my soul apart from itself. You know, and so there's this energy of that, and some of you may take some, you know, take some stuff from that movie Coraline as well. It's funny too, because they're showing me images from the movie, like there's these characters with button eyes. They have buttons for eyes. And these are the characters that come to you and they're like very hypnotizing and like so nice and everything's fine. Like, just trust us. Don't you want this? Like, doesn't this feel good? And Coraline, you know, tries to look past the button eyes. You know, she tries to look past those button eyes because they're a little creepy at first, but like, you know, she sees that these people have good qualities, or, you know, they make her feel so good. And so she can deal with these button eyes, you know? But then in the long run, it's kind of like, were you seeing very clearly? Were the answers like that obvious to begin with? Did you just overlook some of the bigger red flags there? I don't know. That's up to you guys to decide. That's up to the masculines or the feminines. But I do feel like there is a huge difference between your energies. And a very severe consequence to come. Very, very severe consequence to come. This week. Okay? If there's not a significant realization or development, I really feel like the universe is literally passing judgment upon this situation and telling both of you to move on, Forget about the mission. Forget about what it is you came here to do to an extent. You know, history may need to be rewrit. You're definitely not repeating or entertaining a cycle that you're needing to leave. And that needs to be very clear. You are needing to leave these situations, not integrate them together. Like, that's just crazy. You're taking toxicity and putting it on someone else. And the feminine, I think, realizes and sees how toxic this masculine situation is. And it's almost a really big slap in the face. Like, what, did you just think I'd be okay with that after all the suffering I've done? There's definitely an element of that. What, did you just think I would go along with it, even though you've put me through years of trauma? I don't know. I don't think the feminine's into it. That boat of, you know, freaky shit or you know, experimenting or, you know, the lenience is kind of gone. If it doesn't make the feminine sparkle and shine, it's not where she's going. And masculines, I think you really need to get in touch with your higher self, with your soul, because I don't think you really like what you're doing either. Like I said, it's a fix. It's an addiction. It's something that you have created for yourself to fill the void of not having the feminine in your life. And nothing will ever fill that void. So these are some dramatic circumstances, you guys. Just try to keep it cool. Try to keep it cool. Don't lash out at each other. These projections are needing to happen to an extent so that you guys can see each other more clearly. If something's not making you happy, feminines, don't be afraid to leave it. Do not conform to things that are below you or things that you've already been through with this person. No second chances, I see here. No second chances. And then, masculines, I think that you need to really visit the things that may not be wise investments for you. I think that you need to focus on personal growth outside of distractions. I think that you need to stop entertaining people who create blockages or barriers between you and your twin. And really take some time maybe for yourself to gather your thoughts. Because you know there is something that's very important to contemplate. It's regarding your philosophy. It's regarding your mission. It's regarding, you know, certain sabotaging behaviors in the past, whether it be your own past sabotage or the sabotage of others around you. There is so much going on for the masculine. It's no wonder it's posing such a big burden. The feminine is very aware of the burden. But then again, the feminine is being told to protect her energy, to not conform, as they have been shown the detriment of situations like this to twins. And they are not going to entertain it or give license to actions that the masculine has been able to get away with. They're not going to be able to get away with it. They're not going to be able to interact with their feminines if their involvement in these kind of situations doesn't dramatically shift soon. Very, very interesting reading, you guys. I don't know who this was for, and it was very general. A lot of us are going to be receiving messages this week, so again, just kind of hang on tight and see where this goes. but there is forward movement here for the both of you in different ways, so yeah, take care, you guys. I wish you a great week. I hope you enjoyed the astrology. Let me know if you'd like me to go more into astrology and other readings in the future. I can definitely do that for you guys. I love astrology and I've been wanting to incorporate it more. So yeah, let me know what you thought of this. If it resonated, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.